you will have your decision sets. So all these words, nothing, but it all means business analytics. Altogether, at the last, it comes and ends in the word known as business analytics. So first you have to understand what is your problem in your business. Only if you know what is the problem in your business, you will know how to implement your analytics into it. So analytics follows a process that is similar to the scientific methods. So it also starts with the business problem. So always your
madam, problem. Sorry for the interrupt.
Yes, sir.
Madam, sorry for the interrupt.
Yes, sir.
Little bit slow, madam. You have to, you are going fast. Little bit slow.
Okay. Sir. Actually, I have 300 slides, so I thought like I have to finish it.
No problem. But
okay. I'll take time. I'll go a little slow. Okay. Yeah, able to see my screen?
Madam, your screen is visible.
Okay, sir. So analytics is nothing but business. When it comes to business analytics, we have to take care that the problem is defined very clearly. Only when you know your problem, you will be able to put your analytics into it. Otherwise, it is difficult to analyze. For example, I'm starting a supermarket. So first, what should I understand? What is my problem in my supermarket?
The term rocket science is often used to describe a concept that is quite difficult to understand.
How will I differ from the 10 supermarkets which is nearby?
But in this video, we are going to explain the technology behind rockets and rocket engines in a simplified scientific manner.
So first, I'll take my business problems. Business problem is first one is how to
become keep the rocket moving,
number
you have
one,
to eject from it a huge amount of mass
one.
At high speed.
So second one is
this
how
simply
I
Newton's third law of motion,
shop, leaving the 10 shops.
The greater the momentum
three,
the rocket loses,
going
the more
to the 10
force
shops,
or thrust on the rocket.
Sure my shop gets a huge amount of revenue by sales. These all are my business problems. So
to eject the high-speed mass from the rocket,
a
liquid fuel
revenues,
oxidizer
so
mixture is burnt in the rocket combustion chamber.
Some of your problems. So segment your customers to tailor your product.
The combustion
offers.
Chamber also helps
the
fuel and oxidizer to mix in an efficient manner due to its
problems.
Clever mixing design.
For example, even after understanding all this basic business problem, you are
the high-speed jet
like,
is passed through a specially shaped rocket nozzle.
Shops. How does
the
customer,
function of the nozzle is to increase the exhaust velocity even further, thus increasing the rocket's thrust.
This 10 shop. That can be done.
These
otherwise,
kinds of nozzles are called
converging-diverging
nozzles.
There can be like product
the subsonic
offers, which
flow is converted to a supersonic flow with
example,
the help of
if
such
I give
a nozzle.
A bottle with your Horlicks, will they be able to buy it? Or will I, if I give
the liquid
a,
fuel before entering the combustion chamber
Horlicks,
travels entirely around
so
the nozzle body?
You can find they give bottles with
this
boost,
helps to reduce the
boost,
nozzle cover temperature and also results in some energy
project
savings.
Project people like Tendulkar. And your
to pump the fuel and oxidizer at
so
an adequate flow rate,
there
two
is a
pumps are used.
This. So business problem. Now Boost is feeling that they want to change
these
it. Will
pumps
they
are driven by
it?
A turbine, which is connected
that,
to the same shaft
the,
as the pumps. The pump
and,
turbine unit
is
referred to as a
this
turbo
is
pump.
Our,
a gas
consumption.
Generator
so
produces hot gas, which will turn the turbine.
Based on that, how should you improve your business.
A bypassed
what is
stream of fuel and an
business?
Oxidizer are fed
problems.
Into the gas generator for the purpose
so
of combustion.
So whenever you go with your business
exhaust
problem,
from the turbine is mixed with the main rocket
the
exhaust.
Of your work. How will you plan? Analyze all the problem. Estimate the efforts that has to be put
this
on
unit
it.
Of the rocket
and now
is
you
called
can make
the rocket engine.
Case, okay?
The rocket
case.
Engine we have
I'm
discussed
doing all
so
this,
far is more specifically called a liquid propellant rocket engine. They are the most powerful and versatile rocket propulsion systems available.
I could tell this example of Fair and Lovely. So Fair and Lovely was the only company which was giving fairness products. Nobody thought at those times Fair and Lovely belongs to a female alone. Even the male was using Fair and Lovely. Nobody thought that there will be a different product which will come back as Fair and Handsome. So that was known as your problem. Okay. So now like men felt like there was no cream for them. They never had any grooming items and all those. So that was the need for the hour and effort was put in and now it was made, the problem was made into a business case and now they came with a solution of giving your Fair and Handsome and all those. For at this point of time, you require data to build your business case. So like, you have to take a survey among the men and find like, are they willing to have a fairness cream? Like if they are not willing to have a fairness cream and if you are introducing a new cream, it will become a waste for them. So now you have to get a data, collect a data. Either it can be by means of your census is like you would have understand population and everything we take by means of census or you can also go through by means of your survey. So both of that can be used, any of your questionnaire type of surveys. Now we have your Google Forms. Those days we only had questionnaire, paper printed questionnaires where we go and give it to people, get it filled and convert that into Excel, and that's how data was made. So that's how you used to, we have data. So required data has to be taken, and from the data we have to make sure that the business is being built in the form of case. So case is always, you can find data into it, lots of data. Only if data is there, business cases can be resolved to get a solution. So this is very mandatory required. So availability, quality, granularity, frequency, all those have to be put into your data. So your required data should have all this. So next is your approach. Business case has been now been put out. So like what are the quantifiable cost and benefits, like whether it is good, better, best, worst, all those have to be put and find. You have to put a tableau column based on your cost, based on your approach, based on your benefits. People are willing to take it, people are not willing to take it. For example, the same example of your fairness cream here, like you can put like willingness of fairness cream. People are like good, better, best. So like people feel like best. Many of them have given you a survey telling that we are very willing to have a fairness cream. Then your willingness becomes best over there. Okay, so we'll be able to launch it. That is known as your coming out of your business case. Quantifiable cost and benefits can be put in the form of your data. So how will you do this? So first you have to grab it, store it, clean it, analyze, visualize, and interpret. So what is grab it? Grab it is nothing but collection of data. How will you collect it? Either by means of Sensex or your means of your questionnaire. As soon as you make a WhatsApp video call, have you formed all the time, you get like rate, how was your call, were you able to hear, rate it. So that is known as your collection of data, grab it. So each time I could find the data. Why do they want daily we are making calls? Don't they know like today it was here, fine, today that it was not fine, based on their frequency band, are they not able to find it? Even then they want to make a list of it. They want to grab to see daily performance of their video calls. Is there any improvement? For a past month, people were telling it was good. So this month, are they able to, because I have introduced a new technology, so are they able to tell me it is excellent? So that is known as grabbing data. Grabbing data is nothing but collection of data. And next one is store the data. Where will you store the data? The data will be stored in the form of you can have your cloud platforms, like your Google Sheets, Google Documents, and all those are put in your cloud. You don't have a local device where it has been sold. It all so stored in servers where we tell it as cloud data. So cloud can be used, or normally you can also use your Oracle SQL to store your data, where you can have multiple lakhs and crores and millions and billions of data into it. So store your data, very mandatory, you have to store it. And clean it. What is known as cleaning? We'll see in the later classes, later sessions, later slides, but provided I'll tell you. Cleaning is, for example, I'll tell you the live example. HDFC Bank, during 2008, when I joined my bank, the HDFC Bank was not so popular in Kerala. So they want to make themselves popular in Kerala. What they did was, instead of going and starting my bank one by one, it takes me lots of time. So there are some local banks, which are very famous for that state alone. State banks are available, not a public bank, but a private bank, which you can find many branches, but it will be available only in that state. You cannot find it in all the places. So there was a brand which was known as Krishna Bank. Krishna Bank, which was a very famous in Kerala state, where you can find in many branches were available. But it was not so famous outside of Kerala. It was only famous in Kerala. So now HDFC spoke with them, and they had some, either they would have had a, they would have become a thick industry, or they were planning to go beyond it, but they were unable to. They didn't know how to grow, or they didn't have money, or they had some crisis, some of the issues was there, or maybe they didn't know how to progress and they want to bring it high, or they didn't have hire to take care of the business, something. So now HDFC spoke with them, and now they told, okay, for a huge deal, the bank was totally being sold to HDFC. So within a night, how all this Andhra Bank and all those has converted into Union Bank, within a night, automatically, within fraction of seconds, today it was Krishna Bank, tomorrow we had a board known as HDFC Bank in all the Krishna Banks. So today, in one day, we were able to have so much of branches in HDFC. In Kerala, we were able to have so much of HDFC Banks. This is how HDFC got into Kerala. One or two own branches were available, but not to a large extent. When they plan to expand to a large extent, this is how they got into Kerala. So now, data from Krishna Bank in computer was in the, only in the form of Excel, where the data of our customer data in HDFC was very clear. We have data team, business analytics department where I was. We have data team and everything. Cleaning will be done, processing will be done by somebody. So this is how we do it. Collection of data, storing, cleaning, analyzing. And I was into this interpretation and visualization. So we were into this. And but we had a chance of working in all the departments. So cleaning will be done and everything. Now we have the challenge of getting this Krishna Bank data. Krishna Bank data, we didn't know which is the first name. We didn't know which is the last name. There was no space between the first name and last name. There was no phone number and your account number looks the same. So this is known as your cleaning of data. Cleaning of data does not mean all the data are bad data or messy data or garbage of collections of data. No, it's all good collections of data, but provided only one issue is that you will have all your data compiled. For example, the first letter, if I feel like the third letter after that is a first name, sometimes it looks the ulta of it. And if I think the 10-digit number, okay, this is my phone number, maybe there is an account number. So there is a challenge in it. So cleaning of data is very mandatory. There are data analysts purely who have been involved in cleaning of data. So even companies, very huge companies like TCS, CTS and everybody have data analysts purely to clean data. They have multiple metrics for them or multiple tools have been used, but they clean the data. That is also a very challenging job of data analytics. So then you have to do is analyze the data. Once it has been cleaned, you know, as I told in Excel, you can use even the very simplest form of analyzing the data is pivot table. Pivot table can be used to analyze your data. But when it comes to R, Python, R and anything, we use linear regressions, chi-square, we use k-means, clustering means and all those many formulas, many metrics are available. But somehow, ordinary mean can be also used, ordinary standard deviation can be also used to find your analyzing data. Visualizing data, now we are the famous tool of visualization of data nowadays is your Tableau. So Tableau can be used to analyze your data. And the best, if it is web analytics, your Google Analytics is one of the main tools which you can use to visualize your data. We'll see everything in the coming slide. So interpretation can also be made. So sample architectures, how does your sample architectures look? Ordinarily, you can find that this is how normally all your data from your finance, sales, supply chain, everything gets into your data warehouse and comes out in the forms for us this way. So this is your traditional analytics and big data analytics. It has been kept in your Hadoop cluster, like your cloud. And from there, we take every data so that we can take a huge amount of data from that, from your normal things. And as I told you, Excel power users are also there. Affordable, very affordable. If you cannot be, if you tell that I'm willing to do analytics, but like it's all looks very costly, you can go with the basic Excel that is also mandatorily easy for you. Okay, so case study, this is how they frame it, like publicly available credits or their demographic data can be taken. You can build some statistical models and that can be tailored to your telephone people, like BPO people who make business process outsourcing. So they'll be able to sell your credit limit products, your credit cards, credit limits, and all those can be spoken. And like credit, for example, here you can take the example of your credit card. So like credit limit differs from people to people. So how can you give for a person who earns somewhere around 30,000 per month? Can you give him limit of more than 2 lakhs or 3 lakhs? No, you will not be able to give. Yeah, initially there is a pay ban for everybody, which, and if it is he's a businessman, it is different. If it is a salaried person, it is different. So all this from your normal data, we collect it and now we tailor the offers and give it differently to different people. That is the main thing of your case study creations and creating it and coming to a solution. So the main challenges is lots of challenges are there in cleaning of data. Okay, so your data will be found, and some data will be in the form of PDF, some will be in the form of MP3, JPEG, Excel, Move, Docs, and all those. For example, the best example I'll tell you, simplest one, whenever we convert PDF to Word or Word to PDF, you will find that in PDF, maybe a picture when comes over here, it comes in the form of, you'll not be able to select it, it turns into a picture, your Word. So all those are again challenges what we'll have, but there are solutions for all the challenges. There is a main work of people which they are doing it. Okay, and the volume of data is very fast. In the last 2 years alone, it's been told, IBM has told that 90% of data what they have today is being collected only in the last 2 years. So data has been tremendously growing. All the app, whenever you install, you give one thing, what is known as allow. Do you want me to allow, deny, that will come, right? If you don't allow, it will not be installed. So no other go, we'll give allow. It takes your data from your system, from your mobile, it collects, okay? For the best example, I'll tell you, yesterday was, I searched in Google, business analytics. I heard one word where I searched as business analytics. As soon as I came to my PowerPoint presentation, when I typed the first page as business analytics, it gave me suggestions telling that how my first page can look like. All data-related pictures, all analytics-related pictures are coming out over there. So what does it mean that? So something, everything is linked. Well, what I gave in Google, automatically PowerPoint is able to view it. Google's product is different, Microsoft's product is different. Even then, they have a link. Something over there can be collected over here. So these all are known as your collection of data. Okay. So, and you have to understand one thing very, very meaningfully. Whatever you give will be coming out. So if you give poor data, you will get poor prediction of data. Your decision may not be very perfect. So garbage in is the garbage out. So it should depend on either if you are giving a worse data, messy data, if you're able to clean it up, then it's okay. But it does not have any relevance of data. For example, what is the color of dress you wear? I wear a blue dress, green dress, red dress. Okay, that is one. Next column, you're asking how much spending did you make? So people are giving your data. So will there be a blue dress whoever wore was able to spend 1 lakh? Red dress whoever wore was able to spend only 500 rupees. Will you be able to give that? No. That is known as your garbage in and garbage out. What type of data you give in will be the output of your data which come out. So that should be very meaningful when you give your data. Okay. So like understanding all this, I want you to again go to Mendy.com and tell me like what is the importance of business analytics in today's world. Use www.mendy.com. Give the code 844677. I hope you are able to see my screen. So you again go to www.mendy.com. And tell me 844677, give your code and tell me what do you feel importance of business analytics in today's world. It is high. Okay, so one of you have answered. Okay, very good. So there is no low or medium, right? So everybody, maximum 5 people have told that it is high. That's all. Participants, please try Mendy.com 844677. Superb. I could be 6 people telling that it is high. Okay, I could also see somebody telling medium. Very good. Good, good. 8, 9. So totally 10 people have answered. Out of that, 1 tells me like it is medium, and 9 tells me it is high. Try it. Anybody else? Do you have any other opinion? So shall I take this as the final opinion? If anybody else has some other opinion of low, medium. Have got your response only from 10 of you. 11, okay. 12. Superb. 2 of them for medium and 11 of them for high.
Well, some of the participants, they would like to ask some questions. Sir.
They are unable to see my question?
No. In the chat box, they are asking questions. One, two,
okay, three, okay. Three. Importance of business analytics in today's world. 1 minute. Let me... Okay. Hi, it's high, okay. Importance of bottoms of analytics in today's world. Okay. So maximum of you have told it is high. It is high. Okay. So maximum of you have told it is very high. Okay. Very good. So thank you for answering. Let me go back to the presentation. Okay, so let me next get into your so you can understand that many of you gave your opinion telling that your importance for business analytics is very high. I'll agree, not 100%, even 500%, I'll agree that today the purely all the business are based on business analytics. If you do not know analytics, if you do not know